Now let's see the additional evidences. In this verse, again, Allah says, all Ahli Kitab will believe in him. Ahli Kitab means people of the book. People of the book, which are mentioned in the Quran, are Christians and Jews. And in this verse, Allah says, there is not one of the people of the book who will not believe in him before he dies, and on the day of rising, he will be a witness on them. Now, if you pay attention to this underlying part, Allah says, not one of the people of the book, the Christians and Jews, who will not believe in him before he dies. Now, if you think about the first coming of Jesus, there were a very small group who had real faith in Jesus, the disciples. They were little more than 10. The number was little more than 10. So basically, the Christians and Jews of that time, the people of that time, did not have real faith in Jesus. And also the Christians, which lived after Jesus was taken to the presence of Allah, they were oppressed and they did not have real faith. So in order for this verse to be to happen, to be real, Jesus must return back. His followers will triumph. In this verse, Allah says, and I will place the people who follow you above those who are unbelievers until the day of rising. So again, if you think about the first coming of Jesus, the disciples, they were oppressed. And also the followers of Jesus, after Jesus was taken to the presence of Allah, they were oppressed also. So the people who follow Jesus were not above of disbelievers at that time. So again, this verse to happen to be real, he must come back. He must return back again. Let's see other additional evidences. Additional evidence number one. In this verse, Allah says in Quran, remember when Allah said, Isa, son of Maryam, remember my blessing to you and to your mother when I reinforce you with the purest spirit so that you could speak to people in the cradle and when you were fully grown and when I taught you the book and wisdom and the Torah and the Injil and when you created a bird shape and out of clay my permission. Now let's pay attention to this underlying part of the verse. Allah says, I taught you the book, the wisdom, and the Torah and the Injil. Now, this word, book, is the book in question, actually. In this in this part, Allah says, Allah taught Torah and Injil. Of course, at the first his coming, he knew Torah, which was already revealed, and he was revealed Injil, so he knew Injil also. And this book, word book, could only refer to Quran, which he didn't know that time. And in fact, this word book was used in several verses in the Quran, for Quran itself. Now, another evidence. The likeness of Isa in Allah's sight is the same as Adam. Adam, peace be upon him, the prophet. As we know, he was created without any parents. He did not have a father. He did not have a mother. So the similarity between Jesus and Adam is that Jesus, at the time of his second coming, he will not have any parents because his mother lived a long 2,000 years ago and died a long time ago. So at this time of his first, second coming, he will not have any parents. And this is will be a very good sign. And this will be a discriminative sign between false messiahs and the real messiah, Jesus, peace be upon him. He will not have any relatives. Nobody will know him. And he will not have any parents, like as Adam, peace be upon him. And then Allah says, peace be upon me the day I was born, and the day I die, and the day I am raised up again alive. Again, if you pay attention to this underlying part, and the day I die, as we remember from the first verse that we have seen, the number 55, that Ali Imran 55, Allah said that he did not die. He wasn't killed. He was not crucified. But in this verse, Allah says that he will die. In order this real death to happen, he must come back again, and this is a very good evidence for his second coming. Excuse me. Additional evidence number four. Allah says, remember when Allah said, Isa, son of Maryam, remember my blessing to you and to your mother when I reinforce you with the purest rule, so that you could speak to people in the cradle and when you were fully grown. Now, again, if you pay attention to this underlying part, underlying word, fully grown, the Arabic counterpart of this word is Kehlen. Kehlen means, to Islamic, according to Islamic scholars, is an age between 30 and 50s. It indicates an age of full maturity. And according to the Islamic scholars, again, it is about, starts about age 35. As we might remember from his first coming, he was his early 30s when he was taken to the presence of Allah. So in order to live this full age of full maturity between 35 and 50s, he must come back again. Again, in other words, Allah says, the same word is used. He will speak to people in the cradle and also when fully grown, kehlan, and will be one of the salihun. Again, the same word is used, which means that he will live this age of full maturity at the time of his second coming. So, of course, we have a duty to prepare the world for Jesus' second coming. As I started with the very beginning of my speech, as you might remember, I started with there are very powerful ideologies against religion today. The first one is Darwinism. Harun Yahya, that's the reason why Harun Yahya attaches so much importance to Darwinism, the theory of evolution, and the materialist philosophy. However, new scientific evidences from many branches of sciences, many new branches of sciences, from genetics, molecular biology, biochemistry, biology, paleontology, comparative anatomy, all falsify the theory of evolution and the claims of the materialist philosophy, which claims, materialist philosophy claims, that the matter exists forever and will exist for forever. However, with the discovery of Big Bang, the Big Bang theory, definitely falsified materialist claims. And new scientific evidences in many scientific branches that I mentioned before falsifies the claims of the theory of evolution. Now let's take a look at these scientific evidences. But before, Allah has the divine promise to believers. In this verse, Allah gives us a promise. Allah says, Allah has promised those of you who believe and do right actions that He will make them successors in the land as He made those before them successors and firmly establish for them their religion with which He is pleased and give them in place of their fears security. They worship Me, not associating anything with Me. Any who disbelieve after that, such people are deviators. So Allah's promise is, Allah will make the believers successors in the land as He made those before them successors. So definitely, the religious Islamic morality, Islamic morality will prevail throughout the world. So we're living in a time that there was a rise in the atheistic philosophy starting at the 19th century. However, with the new scientific evidence, new scientific discoveries, these irreligious philosophies going down in the whole world, and there is a rise in the religions throughout the world. Now, what about the scientific evidences which refute the theory of evolution? I want to start with Richard Dawkins. Richard Dawkins is a prominent, the number one evolutionist in the world, and he is also a militant atheist. Dawkins says, before Darwin, it was difficult to be an intellectually fulfilled atheist, and Darwin made it easy to become an intellectual atheist. That's the reason why Darwinism is so important, because it denies the existence of a creator and claims that all the living beings are products of coincidences. Now, in the third part, we will continue with the new scientific evidences which falsify the theory of evolution.